Hello everyone and welcome back to week 4 of the South Korean Wrestling League. I'm your host, Scott Hero, and we have some breaking news regarding a matchup last week between Kim Tae-gon and Minho. During that match, Minho did sustain an injury less than 2 minutes in from a dive and headbutt to the chest. Caught him off guard, and it looks like Minho will be out of action for the next 3 to 4 weeks. We aren't fully sure of the timeline yet, but in each person's contract, there was a clause to have a substitute in place in case of an injury. So that is what's going to happen. There will be someone taking the place of Minho for the next few weeks that he's injured. Here is the leaderboard anyway. Park Sang-chul up top, Just Jerry at the bottom. It's not looking good for Just Jerry. He needs to get some points on the board. And here are the matchups for this week. Gu Sang-kyu taking on Jinwoo, which is Minho's replacement. Cedric Soldier vs. Kim Tae-gon. Captain Korea vs. Jade Tiger. Just Jerry vs. Ryu Chan-wook. And Park Sang-chul vs. Kang Dae-sang. Jinwoo, being a former bandmate of Minho, also in the wrestling business, so that's an interesting choice for a replacement. And that match will be up first. Gu Sang-kyu taking on Jinwoo. Is GSK. It's going to be interesting to get into the mind of GSK going into this one. He was expecting to take on Minho, and now he has to take on a new opponent, someone that he hasn't had any experience of seeing any matchups before in this league. Jinwoo coming in completely fresh, taking the place of Minho. Former bandmate, former friend. Well, I'm assuming they still are friends if he's taking the place. But GSK, he's doing well so far. He's in a good position. He just needs to keep up that momentum here tonight. Here comes Jinwoo making his way down to the ring, clearly excited, the rapper of the group. He was trained by Minho, but he hasn't been wrestling for too long, less than 2 years, so he's relatively new to the wrestling business, but Minho trusts him enough to get the job done, so we'll have to see how he can do here tonight. He will be taking the place of Minho for the entire duration of the time Minho is injured. So, Minho trusts him to get those points in his place. Let's see what he can do here tonight. And it looks like we're ready to go in this one. Both men ready to go. And it's going to be interesting to see Jinwoo, first time in action here tonight, starting off quick. And if this is the first time you're joining in, seeing the action here, every matchup, 10 minute time limit, Iron Man match rules. Whoever has the most falls after 10 minutes gets 3 points. Loser gets 0. If it does end in a tie, both men will walk away with 1 point apiece. Everyone is fighting it out, with the prize at the end of the season being the first ever man to be the SKWL heavyweight champion. Everyone wants that award, of course. But GSK, he's in unknown waters right now. He is doing well himself. He can hold his own against anyone, but Jinwoo coming in completely fresh. GSK has been wrestling every single week so far. Jinwoo taking the place of Minho, who got injured last week in that matchup against Kim Tae-gon. A giant loss, put Minho all the way down in the 9th place in the leaderboard. The only man lower is Just Jerry, who has yet to even pick up a single point after the first 3 weeks of action. But Minho trusts Jinwoo to get the job done. We'll see how he can do here tonight in his first ever matchup. He was trained by Minho, and Minho, of course, is a bit of a high flyer. Jinwoo, similar body type, you know, he's a bit of a smaller man, agile and quick from the get-go. They'll have similar move sets, I'm assuming. We'll see how we can do here tonight. Hooking him up, slamming him down, that could be a fall right there. One, two, and a kick out by GSK. We can't count GSK out though, just because, you know, he's been wrestling these past few weeks. Like, he's in a decent position on the leaderboard! Swanton bomb from the top! 2 minutes down in the timer. One, two, and a three! And just like that, Jinwoo's 1-0 up. Minho's gonna be watching on from home, pretty proud right now. Minho hasn't been off to a great start. He got 3 points in the first week, but then since then, two back-to-back losses with an injury. So he's currently 9th place on 3 points. But if Jinwoo can pick up a massive win here, what an arm drag! Against GSK, you've got to imagine Minho is going to be happy with that. We'll see how it goes though. Jinwoo was the rapper of Minho's group. Minho being the lead vocalist, Jinwoo being the rapper. Popular in his own right, very popular among South Koreans. Covered in tattoos, as you can see, he became a bit of an outcast after leaving the group himself. Followed in Minho's footsteps, I guess, by becoming a professional wrestler. The two have always been close friends! Superman punch to the face, though. But Jinwoo, less experienced. He hasn't been wrestling for long, like mentioned, less than 2 years, relatively fresh. Oh, Jinwoo with the stomp to the midsection though from the top rope. Right now, what's Jinwoo going for? What's GSK going for? Spinning him prettier! That could be enough to keep him down. One, two, three! And there we go, it's level yet again, 1-1. Looks like GSK is finding his rhythm. And it looks like he might have just bust open Jinwoo with a cut just above the eye there. It's getting brutal already. Not the stumps. Not the stumps to the head on the outside. He's making Jinwoo wonder if it was worth it. Was it worth coming into this league? It's supposed to be the best of the best, Jinwoo less experienced. That's why he was down as a substitute, just in case. Not quite good enough to make the initial roster. And GSK is making him pay right now. The strikes, my god. Jesus, it doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. The chops, the kicks. GSK down as well. Getting a bit tired after that onslaught there, but ever since just before the fall, Jinwoo hasn't done a thing. It's been all GSK, making him pay, making him suffer. That's why he is the red shot. Making people red, as he has with Jinwoo. Blood starting to trickle down their forehead. It looked like he was getting back into it, but not for long! White noise! Signaling for something here. He's got his eye on the target. Kick to the midsection. Got him up. Hooked. And face first down onto the mat. Straight into the cover. One, two, and it is a three. And just like that, GSK takes the lead. And he's got him hooked again for an unprettier. Spin an unprettier. Straight into the cover. He's not messing around in this one. He wants that lead. Two and a three. And within the space of 10 seconds, GSK takes a lead and gets a two fall lead just like that. And right now, Jinwoo is in huge trouble. He could tap out. Doesn't though. Minho, probably sitting at home, he was happy for a while, maybe not so much anymore. GSK very confident right now. 3-1 lead. Jinwoo hasn't been able to do anything. Disaster kick. Stomps to the back. Welcome to the welcome to the league, Jinru. Brutalizing. This is not the opponent Jinru wanted in his first match. The blood starting to just get all over the mat now. That cut is opening up wider and wider. Covering the mat. What an introduction to the league. If Jinru gets injured, who takes his place? I don't think we accounted for two injuries from the same person. Well, a replacement injury. Wasn't expected. Knee to the face. Kick to the side of the face. This is pure domination now. GSK just creating a highlight reel here. Going for that spin and a pretty again. Into the cover. One, two, three. 4-1. 4-1. What happened? Jinru in trouble. His blood all over the mat. We're gonna have to switch this mat after this match. But it has been all GSK since maybe 3 minutes into the match. And another fall. Wow. Like mentioned, Jinru lesser experienced. And he's just getting completely dominated. Yeah, but a reversal! Managing to get out of that one. Can he get something back into this one now? I don't even think he knows where he is completely. That blood all over his face. Might have got in his eyes. He's a bit blinded right now. GSK ducking underneath. Leapfrog. And punch! Straight punch to the face. Jinru trying to retreat into the corner. That's not going to work. Just washing the side of the head. GSK relentless. Up to the top rope with the moonsault, but missing. Jinru managing to move out the way of that one, but not for long. Taking him inside and out with that clothesline. Into the cover. One, two, and a three. And just like that, 6-1. Lead. This is not what Minho wanted, and it's not what Jinru was expecting. The poor guy coming in as a replacement and getting brutalized. Is he even going to want to continue these next few weeks while Minho's injured? My god. The blood pouring out of the head. GSK showing how dangerous of a man he is. He's been doing well, but I don't think anyone's counted him as a favorite so far. But maybe this is his showcase, just to show. Don't take him lightly. GSK wanting to be that first ever SKWL Heavyweight Champion and showing why he's worthy here tonight. Complete domination so far. But Jinru now with an arm drag. Following up with a drop kick. Can he get something back in this one? Going into the cover, you can see the blood all over the face. Two. And a kick out. Not going to be enough. He's just trying to fight back in with only 20 seconds left. He needs to do something. Something at all to show why he's Minho's replacement. But he's not put on a good show in here tonight. Got hooked up. Down he goes. Into the cover. Is there enough time? Referee getting into position. One, two, three. And it is another fall with just 1 second left. Complete domination by GSK. 7-1 victory. My god, welcome to the league, Jinru. He's not going to want to come back next week after that one, if that's the type of opponent he has to face. But huge win by GSK, cementing himself in the first position on the leaderboard right now. And up next we have Saja Soldier taking on Kim Tigon. Here he is, the soldier, making his way down to the ring. He's had a mixed bag of success so far in this league, currently sitting in 8th position. He picked up a massive win in week 1 over Captain Korea, but since then, not been doing so well, 2 back-to-back losses. He's just trying to find his position in this league, not a front runner anymore. He was top of the league after week 1, we are only in week 4, there's still plenty of time 18 weeks in total, so there's a long way to go, but he's been at the very top, and right now he's close to the very bottom. Opponent, Tim Tigon, the man responsible for putting Minho on the injury shelf, on the injury list, I should say. Currently undefeated, 1 win, 2 draws in his first 3 matches. Looking very good. He's going to want to keep up that momentum here tonight. He's feeling confident and cocky. No one managing to give him a loss yet, and he's going to want to keep that up here tonight. Both men ready to go in this one. Sergio Soldier, Kim Tigon. The second matchup of week 4. And we're off. The referee rings the bell. Interesting matchup, this one. Sergio Soldier, a bit of a submission specialist. Kim Tigon, we've seen his speed, athleticism on display. The Soldier, a bit of a smaller body type, but insanely powerful in his own right. He was able to pick up Captain Korea with ease, who is the biggest man in this league. So he has the strength, he has the skills. He's just been a bit unlucky these past 2 weeks with back-to-back losses, but he's here tonight, he's in the ring, and in the early goings, all over Kim Tigon. Knee to the arm there, going over the head as well. He knows that he needs to get some points. Kim Tigon faking him to the outside though. Slamming him against the apron. Kick to the head. And there's the senton. He's been doing that senton a lot over these past few weeks. A signature move of his. On the outside, less protection on those mats with a back suplex. We've seen people take the action at the outside over these first few weeks. Get someone injured on the outside where there's less protection, less padding on the floors. Get them back on the inside of the ring for the falls. It's been a smart strategy, one that Kim Tae-gon's done himself over these few weeks, and it looks like he's doing it again here. Referee up to a count of 6, maybe going for a count out? He's just going to wait. Is Sergio Soldier going to get back in the ring in time? Kim Tae-gon maybe messing around there, he's making the refs count a bit slower. Referee up to a count of 8, Sergio Soldier getting back to his feet, 9! Is there enough time? Just getting back in the ring in time at a count of 9. Close, very close, that could have been the first fall right there. Sergio Soldier does get himself back in the ring though, and is back on the offense right now. Chop! Elbows connect into the midsection. Kim Tae-gon just stuck in that corner right now. His face getting dragged along that top rope. Soldier can do anything he wants to try and win. Suplex in the middle of the ring. And as mentioned, submission specialist going for an STF. This has made people tap out in the past. Can Kim Tae-gon survive? And it looks like he does so. He gets out of it. Not many people survive in the STF of Sergio Soldier, the Lion Soldier. And is he going for another submission here? Going after those legs again. Kim Tae-gon this time fighting out of it. Kick to the side of the head. And going for it. Stundog Millionaire out of nowhere. Into the cover. Will that be enough for the first fall? 1, 2. But no, a kick out at 2. Kim Tae-gon a bit frustrated. He thought he caught the Soldier off guard. Could be going for that shooting star press. got many a fall from it, but no, the soldier getting back up to his feet, instead going for an axe handle. Taking away those arms, taking away the strength of the soldier. Going up top again, he wants to hit that shooting star press, you know he does. And no! The soldier rolling out the way on that one. He went high risk. It didn't pay off. The soldier manages to see it in time. And it's still anyone's game. The soldier going back after those legs again, trying to get the submission. Kintagon fighting out of it again. Hurricanrana. We're almost halfway through this one. Still anyone's match. Shooting star press! That time connects! Can he capitalize? He's not going straight in the cover. There he goes. One, two, and the soldier kicks out. Unbelievable. Still anyone's matchup. No one giving away anything. Back and forth action. No one yet to take the lead. We're almost halfway through the time. The soldier leapfrog and a running knee. That could be enough. He needs to drag Kintagon away from the ropes, and he does so. He needs to go into the cover. He's wasting too much time. Instead, maybe looking for a submission. He gets it. That regal stretch. And Kintagon tapping out. No choice. Saving his energy. Tapping out quickly. Oh. I thought the soldier was going for another submission. Hands into the mouth. New moves shown off here by Sedja Soldier. We haven't seen him do that one before. Going for that knee, but Kintagon rolling out of the way. The soldier, though, trying to stay on him. Not quite working out as expected. Bouncing off the ropes. Poison Rana from the middle rope. Kintagon going up top again. Can he reach the shooting star press from there? All the way across the ring, and he does! Connects into the cover. Trying to make it level. One, two, three, and he does so. 1-1. Still anyone's match. So evenly matched are these two competitors. This could go either way. The soldier want to get his position back on the leaderboards. Trying to get back up those ranks. Kintagon wanting to stay undefeated as he has done so far in these first 3 weeks. Still anyone's game. 1-1 at the minute. 3 minutes 45 remaining. Here come the strikes from the soldier. Reversed. Kintagon throwing him against the ropes. Ducks underneath. Leapfrog. And a big elbow to the side of the head. Just dropping him in his tracks. Just like that. Wrench in the head of the soldier. Slamming back down is Kintagon in control right now. With just over 3 minutes left. Is he going for another shooting star press? He could be. And he is connected. Straight into the cover. One, two, three. And there we go. Kintagon takes the lead. 2-1. The soldier's got his work cut out now to get back into this one. 3 minutes left on the clock. Still time remaining, of course, but the seconds are ticking down. Soldier trying to fight back anyway. Punches to the side of the head. Going for a suplex attempt, maybe. Yes, he is. He's dropping him down. Knee to the side of the head. Brutal. So he's waiting. Waiting for something big here. Running cutter! Taking down Kintagon. The soldier also still hurting though. Arm draped across the chest. One, two, and a kick out. A kick out from Kintagon. He does not want to go back level. Massive move though. He's got to be hurting. Going for that kick to the side of the head. Connects, but just slightly. Ducks underneath. Leapfrog. Running knee attempt reversed. And Stundog Millionaire again. He's not going for the cover though. Interesting. That could have been enough to keep the soldier down, but instead going after the arm. The soldier retreating into the corner slightly here. Pentagon caught him off guard there with a stun dog. And he's waiting for him to get back up to his feet. Right behind him, look out, soldier! Slammed head first into the mat. One, two, three, and there we go. 3-1 now to Kim Tae-gon. The soldier only has a minute left on the clock to get back into this one. But right now, Kim Tae-gon feeling good. He wants another 3 points on the board. He wants to stay undefeated. Elbow to the side of the head. And another elbow. He's just making the time go down here, keeping the soldier cornered. He's two falls ahead with 35 seconds left to go. DDT, I think that might have bust him open. 30 seconds left on the clock. The soldier not in a good position right now. Kim Tae-gon signal and get back up. Big drop kick, massive drop kick. He's not even going for a pin. Wait. Stun dog millionaire again. And again, not going for the cover. He seems quite content with a 3-1. Going up top. Maybe going for a shooting star press. And a fake out by Kim Tae-gon. A fake out, but a 3-1 victory. Nonetheless, big 3 points on the board. Stays undefeated. Gets another 3 points. He's happy with that, of course. What a baller. Big win. And up next, Captain Korea versus Jade Tiger. Here comes the captain. Sitting on 4 points in seventh right now. The powerhouse of the league. With the draw last week against Kang Desang. Taking on Jade Tiger, another powerhouse, the two power men of the league. The two masked men of the league. It's going to be an interesting matchup. There he is, Jade Tiger, also on 4 points in fifth, a fan favourite. A lot of people want him to win the entire thing. Can he do so here tonight? Can he pick up 3 points against the captain? Ready, Captain Korea focused, Jade Tiger focused, staring each other down. The two masked men of the league battling it out here tonight. Very similar styles, there is a bit of a height difference. Captain Korea obviously the taller man, Jade Tiger one of the smaller men in the league, but two powerhouses in their own right. I think this is the matchup that a lot of people have been waiting for. The captain versus the tiger. And right now, Captain Korea in control. On the middle rope, what's he going for? Big shoulder tackle. Taken down, Jade Tiger. Jade Tiger with the running neck breaker though. Never count him out. Both men on 4 points. Both men doing decent so far in the league. One win, one draw, one loss. Similar records. Well, the same record, the same points. Similar styles, very evenly matched. It's going to be a good matchup. As the captain now, neck breaker. Taking down Jade Tiger just like that. A lot of time to go in this matchup. Plenty of time for a cover right now, though. Only one count. Captain Korea maybe trying to end things early. Although the match wouldn't have ended, it would have continued for the full 10 minutes, but he could have picked up an early fall. Clothesline. Taking down Jake Tiger. And the captain's got him up. Down he goes. That could be enough for a fall. Maybe not, though. Captain instead deciding to go for something else. Maybe went for that Dominator. Got him up. And Dominator! Down he goes, straight into the cover, not messing around. Hooks the leg. One, two, and a kick out of two from Jade Tiger. The captain can't believe it. He thought that would have been enough. Just 2 minutes down in this one. Slamming the back of his head down onto the mat is Captain Korea. Jade Tiger, his head getting pounded against that mat right now. The captain being a bit brutal there. Wrenching on the head, maybe, you know, if the mask gets out of position, you know, Jade Tiger could be blinded a bit. The captain knows this too well himself. Also wearing a mask as he goes up to the top rope now. Diving senton from the top. That could be enough. All that way down into the midsection. One, two, and a three. And just like that, the captain 1-0 against Jade Tiger. 7 minutes left to go. Still a lot of time left in this one. Running at him. Knee missing. Reversal. Jade Tiger throwing the captain off the ropes. Grabs him in midair. Slamming him down. What strength on display. But only a one count. Unbelievable resilience from the captain. Does not want to stay down. Jade Tiger a bit stunned. He doesn't know what he's supposed to do. Insane strength on display. The referee caught in the corner between these two men. He needs to move out of the way. Jade Tiger got him up. Slamming him down. Not going for the cover though, instead deciding to wait as the captain slowly gets back up to his feet. Jade Tiger going for that power bomb, perhaps. Down he goes, and it's a rope break. It's too close to the ropes. This was the same problem that happened last week with Jade Tiger. He goes for that running power bomb, but he's not positioning himself well. His opponents keep getting caught in the ropes. He keeps getting rope breaks. He needs to sort this out going forward. His ring awareness is not very good at all. It could end up being the downside of Jade Tiger as he goes for a kick there. Missing, but still managing to get the upper hand on the captain anyway. Slamming him face first into that apron. Jade Tiger could have been level though if the powerbomb, if he just positioned it more into the middle of the ring instead of towards the ropes, as the captain reverses the German suplex. And just a club and blow to the chest on the outside. Referee up to a count of six. Seven now. Jade Tiger deciding to get back in the ring. He could be waiting for a count out. Eight. The captain is still down. Jade Tiger feeling it. Referee up to nine. The captain getting up to his feet. Is it going to be enough time? 10. Not quite enough time. And Jade Tiger levels it up with a count out. We are 1-1 now in this one. Jade Tiger grabbing a count out fall. We haven't seen much of them so far in the league. But any fall counts in this one. Back level now. DDT from the captain though. Maybe could have been a smart strategy from the captain. Stay down on the outside. Recover as much time as he needs with the captain's uppercut. Out of nowhere. One, two, three. And he did just that. He recovered just as much as he needed to. Yes, he sacrificed a fall, but straight back in. Gets the upper hand and gets a fall of his own. Back in the lead now. Jade Tiger got the captain up though. Spinning powerbomb. This time away from the ropes. One, two, and a kick out from the captain though. Rolling to the outside to recover yet again. Jade Tiger running at him, jumping over the top rope. My God. The athleticism lands on his feet, completely takes the captain out. Unbelievable athleticism. Straight into the German suplexes, two. And a third one. Referee also up to a count of three at the same time. What athleticism on show from Jade Tiger. Somersault over the top rope, landing on his feet after colliding with the captain. Unbelievable strength, unbelievable athleticism. Into a busting crab now. But it's not going to do much. Not on the outside. Referee up to a count of eight. The captain stunned, doesn't know where he is. Referee on a count of nine. The captain doesn't realize the count. 10, and Jade Tiger straight away running, taking him out. He was waiting for that fall. The second count out from Jade Tiger. And as soon as the referee counted 10, Jade Tiger pounced, not letting the captain recover any time at all after that 10 count. Jade Tiger in control now, but we are level with just over 2 minutes left on the clock. Still anyone's game. Elbow drop from the top. Going for those German suplexes again on the inside. Look at the strength on display. Able to easily throw around the bigger man. Third one connects. Could be going for that powerbomb again. He's got him in position. Got to move him away from the ropes though. Down he goes. And another rope break. He's costing himself precious falls, but he waits again for the captain to get back up to his feet. No reversal. Captain grabbing him. Got him up. Dominator. Into the cover. One, two, three. It was all Jade Tiger for quite a while. But one Dominator keeps the Tiger down. And it's 3-2 to the captain now. Just 1 minute left on the clock. Can Jade Tiger level this up? Going for a dive and splash. Not following it up with a cover though. There's only 1 minute left. If he wants to draw this equal, he needs to do something fast. Captain with the reversal. Got him hooked. Just thrown him across the ring. What a move from the captain. Jade Tiger making his way back up to his feet again, but the captain grabs him. Got him up for the Dominator again. Jade Tiger slammed down onto the mat. That could be another fall. One, two, three. And it is 4-2 to Captain Korea right now. 18 seconds left on the clock. Such evenly matched competitors, but it looks like this one's going to go to the captain. Right hook to the side of the jaw. Only 5 seconds left. The captain climbing to the top rope. Senton. Just missing. But it doesn't matter either way. Captain Korea. 4-2 victory. He takes the 3 points in this one. Good win over Jade Tiger. Incredible matchup. And up next we have Just Jerry taking on Ryu Chun-Woo. We'll be right back. Yet again, I would like to give a big special shout out to WPW, our sponsor here at SKWL. Go check them out. Link in the description, of course. Return them soon. But right now, just Jerry making his way to the ring. Bottom of the leaderboard. 0 wins, 0 draws, 3 losses. Always got a smile on his face though, always feeling good. He's just yet to pick up any points. Dead last, but can he do so here tonight? And here's Ryu Chenwu. He's off to a bad start, but he's starting to find some form now. A draw and a win in his last 2 matches. Obviously still early goings in here. We've only had 3 matches so far, but you've got to think, anyone who comes up against just Jerry right now has got to feel pretty confident that they can get a win, with Jerry still unable to pick up anything in the league thus far. The only man to still be on 0 points. Here we go, 10 minutes on the clock. Just Jerry, Ryu Chenwu. And they're going. And Jerry also going. Athleticism on display straight away. Jerry's been pretty unfortunate so far in the league. That's the best way I can put it. The only man on 0 points. 3 losses, back to back to back. Hasn't been a good start for Jerry. Dead last. He needs to start picking up some points though. I mean, yes, we still have a long way to go. But if he's just going to continue to get loss after loss, it's not going to end up well for him. As he goes for an early cover here, but only gets a 1 count. It feels like there's been a bit of a pattern in Jerry's matches though, where he started off fast, got the upper hand, and in the second half of the match, his endurance just runs out. And he ends up getting pretty dominated. Don't know if that'll be the case here tonight though. Chenwu also having similar struggles. Although as mentioned, he's starting to find his form. But one of the least experienced men in the league as far as wrestling ability is Chenwu. But he's had similar issues as Jerry has, but he has started to figure them out, where he started off well and his endurance, his stamina has been running out towards the end. So, similar styles in a way. They've both got the same issue. Just Jerry's been having it a bit worse, I guess. But as mentioned, Chenwu is starting to figure that out. He knows what he needs to do now. A big win last week. He just needs to keep up the momentum now that he's figured out a game plan. As Jerry goes in for the cover, too. Bit of kick out. Jerry, the master of the moonsault, going up top. He could be going for one here. Looks like it! And Chenwu moving out of the way. Seeing that one coming. Clothesline taking him down. Chenwu now going up top. That Jerry is so far across the ring. Can he even reach? Going for an elbow drop. And it looks like he did connect to the head. Into the cover. One. Just a kick out of one, though. He definitely didn't connect with all of that elbow drop, but he did hit the face of Jerry. Face first flapjack though, and that connects for sure as he goes in for another pin. One, two, and a kick out from Jerry again. Chenwu getting a bit frustrated. Two pin attempts, back to back, both kicked out of. As Chenwu now with the strength up on the shoulders. Spin out, F5. Into another cover. One, two, And another kick out from Jerry. Chandler can't believe it, hitting the mat. Three attempts at a fall. All three kicked out from Jerry. Chandler on the top rope. Dives to the outside! Massive, massive body splash to the outside of the ring from potentially the heaviest man in this league. Under the smallest man in the league, the youngest man, Jerry, at just 19 years of age. Chanwook, he could have just broken one of Jerry's, like, I don't know, his ribs. But Jerry's staying alive in this one, though. Resilient. Into a submission now. Chanwook's on the outside of the ring, though, Jerry. You've got to get him back inside first. You're just wearing him down. Chanwook fighting out of it. Maybe that was a strategy. Maybe just to wear him down. Maybe not specifically looking for a tap out attempt. Chanwook, though, getting Jerry back on the inside of the ring. Going up top again. The big man has been going up top a lot in this one. Elbow drop to the back. Jerry tried to roll out of the way, but he didn't quite get far enough. We don't usually see Chandler going up top, but so far he's been going up a lot. Maybe trying to change his arsenal a bit. Stay different, stay unexpected. Spin out powerbomb though. 2-3. Kenny goes 1-0 up against Jerry. Jerry in a similar position that we've seen him in every week so far. Currently down a fall for Chandler. Still 5 minutes left in this one though. Still plenty of time to get back in. But that flapjack is going to do some damage. Chanwook though also starting to get tired. 1, 2, 3. And Jerry, 2 falls down now. Chanwook taking a big lead. Still obviously 5 minutes left in this one though. Plenty of time. We're only halfway through. But we have seen Jerry in this position too many times. What was that? Unbelievable from just Jerry. Spin them inside now too. Not enough for a fall though. Just a 2 count. Jerry surprised, catching Chanwook off guard. Don't know what that was, but unbelievable. Not quite enough to keep Chanwook down though. Jerry's fighting though. He's a fighter. Can we see him pick up his first point? 2 falls down, 4 minutes left on the clock. Needs to start doing something. Those 2 falls, it might not seem like a lot, and it might seem quick to get back in it, but the timer continues to tick down and will do. Kick to the side of the head. Jerry sees that he's in position, going for those triple moonsaults perhaps. Bottom rope. Middle rope connects. And the master of the moonsault going up top. Top rope moonsault into the cover. 1, 2, 3, and he gets a fall back. 3.5 minutes left. Jerry, please. Everyone wants to see you finally pick up a point. Can you do so here tonight? Chanwook, though, back up to his feet. Knee to the side of the head. Jerry, go for the pin. Chanwook caught off guard. Jerry's been all over him right now for a while, and maybe going for a moonsault. Massive moonsault. Not going for the cover though. What are you doing, Jerry? Another moonsault. Springboard. 1, 2, 3, and there we go. It's level. It's level. It's 2-2. Unbelievable. Jerry could be going for the people's moonsault. Bouncing off the ropes. Bouncing off the other side. Turning around. Standing moonsault connects. Into the cover. 1, 2, 3. Jerry does it. It's 3-2. It's unbelievable. 2.5 minutes left on the clock. Jerry, for the first time in the league history, has taken the lead. It is 3-2, Jerry. You can't get too confident now. You've got to stay on him. Still 2 minutes left. Can Jerry do what everyone has been waiting for from the start? Can he pick up some points? Unbelievable. A 3-match streak of losses. And right now, it's looking good. Springboard moonsault. Into the cover again. One, two, three. Jerry, it's just Jerry with a 4-2 lead. This is unbelievable. Chanwook now running at him, gets arm dragged. Chanwook has been caught off guard. Maybe he came into this one feeling too confident. He got a quick two falls. And ever since those two falls, it's been all Jerry. A comeback for the ages. 2-0 down to 4-2 with 1 minute 20 left on the clock. He just needs to hold out to pick up his first points in the league. Chanwook, though, realizing there's not much time left, finally finding his sense. Is he going to stomp on Jerry's parade with just over a minute left? Picking Jerry up. Power bomb. One, two, three. And it's 4-3 with 50 seconds left. This is the danger time for Jerry. Chanwook in control, only 45 seconds left, and he realizes it, taking a big deep breath there, realizing he needs to keep Jerry down now with only 30 seconds left to get anything out of this one. Even a draw would be enough, but Jerry though, moonsault into the cover. One, two, three. Jerry, 5-3, 20 seconds left. We could be about to witness history here. We could see Jerry's first points with a big win over Ryu Chanwook. Clothesline in the corner. Got him up and DDT! And that's all she wrote. My God, unbelievable. Just Jerry picking up his first 3 points in the league. 5-3 win over Ryu Chanwook. And as always, dancing, he's happy. He can't believe it. He's finally picked up his first points in the lead. This is what he's waited for all this time. What a matchup. And up next, the final match, Park Sang-cho versus Kang Dae-san. Comes Park Sang-cho. Last week, attacking Kang Dae-san after his match against Captain Korea, trying to get an advantage going into this week with an attack out of nowhere. Despicable is Park Sang-cho. But wait, here's Kang Dae-san from behind. He didn't take that attack lightly last week. Going after Park Sang-cho before the bell has rang during his entrance. Knee to the side of the head. Park Sang-cho caught completely off guard. Another man who is yet to be defeated is Park Sang-cho. If he was to win here tonight, he would put him in the top position in first place in the league. He was top at the start of this week. He's wanted to keep that position, but right now, Kang Dae-san all over Park Sang-cho. Obviously not happy with the fact he was attacked after his match last week. No respect from Park Sang-cho. Taking any way he can to win. But Kang Dae-san trying to fight back. His knee hitting that concrete though. And Park Sang-cho. Knee to the nether regions. The regions you never want a knee to be put. He's trying to throw Kang Dae-san down towards the ring. Just throwing him down there. Kang Dae-san just being thrown around by Park Sang-cho. Trying to get him in the ring. Maybe just trying to get the bell to ring in this one. But no, Kang Dae-san with the reversal. Trying to get Park Sang-cho back into the ring now. Maybe trying to start this matchup. Does so. The bell has rang. Kang Dae-san taking Park Sang-cho down. Getting angry. He's waited for this for a full week. We've got to imagine Kangdo Sang angry. He just wants to get the 3 points. Going in for an early cover. Two count. Not quite enough though. Yes, Park Sang-chul was attacked on the runway, but it's still early goings. And, you know, we've seen Park Sang-chul do as much as he can to stay in the lead. Currently on two wins, one draw. Kangdo Sang though, wanting to make him pay into another cover. One. And just a one count yet again. Sang-chul may be the most resilient man in this league. And Kangdo Sang, a man of pride, did not appreciate being attacked after his match last week. Retaliating here tonight. Each man obviously wants to be the heavyweight champion. Throwing Sang-chul across the ring. And again, into the ropes. Oh, going for a hurricanrana, but reversed into like a powerbomb type move. Spinebuster, perhaps. Almost catches Desang off guard. Kick to the midsection. Going for a spin and pile driver. Brutal. Dropped him down on his head. One. Two. But it's a kick out at two. Sang-chul obviously annoyed at that one. That spin and pile driver is brutal. Going in for a submission now. Into that sharpshooter. Made many a man tap out. Kangdo Sang, not one of them though, managing to survive. 2 minutes gone, 8 minutes left on the clock. Gotta admit, this isn't gonna be much of a wrestling fight. This is, well, a wrestling match. This is gonna be a fight. This is gonna be a war between these two. One, two, and a kick out. Clothesline taken down Desang. Tripping him up though. Back and forth, back and forth. Desang has been waiting a week. Kick to the face. Into the cover. Will that be enough to keep him down? One, two, and another kick out from Park Sang-chul. Desang trying to stay on top of Sang-chul now. So that roundhouse kick missing. Clothesline takedown. Sang-chul too aware of what was going on there. He knows what Desang does. And another reversal. Sweeping out the legs. And Desang going up top. Sang-chul on the outside. Elbow drop. And he misses. He lands on that elbow. Kang Desang not known for going up top. High risk, high reward, and that kind of didn't pay off, but he's shook it off anyway. Knee to the side of the head. Picking him up for a powerbomb on the outside of the ring. Dangerous, dangerous move. Not much pattern there on the outside. You can see we have those mats down, but it doesn't absorb that much damage. A lot more impact on the outside of the ring compared to the inside. Elbow drop again across the neck. Into the cover. One, two, and a kick out at two. Kangdo Sang up to the middle rope now. Again, missing though from the ropes. He should stay focused, stay with the strikes, which is what he's good at. But instead, maybe going. Trying something different! Catching Park Sang-chul off guard with that back heel kick. Two, three! And there we go. Kangdo Sang gets the lead. 1-0 out of nowhere with that spinning heel kick. Open-toed, as you can see, Kangdo Sang does not wear any sort of protection on his feet. No wrestling boots for him. The Taekwondo expert, black belt, just heel to the face, and it was enough to keep Park Sang-chul down there. Currently in the lead, 1-0. Sang-chul though, pile driver yet again. on top of the head first onto the mat. One of the most dangerous moves in professional wrestling. And instead of going for the pin, he was trying to go for a submission, but Daesang seen it coming. Kick to the side of the face though. Punch. What's he doing here? Got his legs hooked. And just bouncing off the middle ropes. Guillotined off of those middle ropes there. The time is ticking down though. We have just over 4 minutes remaining. Tang Daesang currently in the lead, 1-0. Park Sang-chul bounced off the ropes. Hurricanrana takedown. Sweeping the legs though. With Sang-chul not staying down for long. Trying to drag Tang Daesang away from the ropes, but instead goes to the outside, catches him, and spins Sang-chul inside and out with that clothesline. Tang Daesang has the lead here, and yes, he'll be happy with the lead, but I don't think his objective here tonight is to care so much about points. He just wanted to get revenge on Park Sang-chul for last week. Sang-chul may be regretting his decision here. He's obviously been flustered starting this matchup. He didn't expect to be cut! And another kick to the head! Caught off guard as he gets back in the ring. And just like that, it's 2-0. Two roundhouse kicks out of nowhere. But there's a spin and pile driver. Tang Daesang right next to the ropes though. Can he kick out? One, two, and he does so. Look at the shock on the face of Park Sang-chul. He's been caught off guard twice now with those roundhouse kicks, heel kicks. 2.5 minutes left, and he's 2-0 down. For the first time in the league, Sang-chul is in trouble. His undefeated streak could be coming to an end here tonight. He doesn't have much time left to make something happen. His lower back obviously in pain though. As Tang Daesang rolls to the outside again, trying to waste some time. He knows he's just got to survive another 2 minutes. Park Sang-chul though, with a sharpshooter on the outside of the ring. It doesn't matter if Tang Daesang taps out on the outside, which he's doing so. It doesn't matter. It doesn't count as a fall. He needs to be inside the ring. Maybe Sang-chul was trying to do some damage, but he doesn't have much time left. He needs to get two falls back. Referee up to a count of three. Sang-chul getting back inside the ring. Maybe hoping for a count out here. Taking some time for a sit down. Tang Daesang getting back up to his feet though. It's not going to be enough for a count out. And he catches him, belly to belly takedown. Into the cover. One, two, three. And it's 3-0. It's 3-0 with 1 minute left on the clock. Sang-chul's undefeated streak coming to an end. Knee to the face, Kinshasa. Into the cover. But he's too close to the ropes. 3-0. 50 seconds left. The spin and heel kick again. One, two, and a kick out. Unbelievable. Park Sang-chul realizing he's got to do something, but he doesn't have the energy to fight back. Only 30 seconds left. Maybe kicked out on instinct alone there. 3-0. Tang Daesang up top, diving axe handle. 20 seconds. It's too late. Park Sang-chul realizes this. It's too late. He can't get three falls in the last 10 seconds now. Powerbomb under the guardrail. My God, is he just trying to injure Tang Daesang? Realizing there's not any time left. Tang Daesang, the winner. Park Sang-chul with a chair though. Going after that leg. Unbelievable. That spinning back heel. Can't do that anymore if he's hurt. Trying to injure the leg. An evil man is Park Sang-cho. What a man. What a man. Do not trust him. But that is going to be it for week 4 of the South Korean Wrestling League. Let's look at the leaderboards. Gusan Q up top with 9 points. Kim Tae-gon in second alongside Kang Dae-sang with 8. Park Sang-cho, Captain Korea on 7. Jade Tiger and Ryu Chan-wook on 4. 3 points apiece for Seja Solda, Just Jerry and Minho all the way at the bottom. Jinwoo not doing the job for Minho, but here are next week's matchups. Kim Tae-gon taking on Just Jerry. Ryu Chan-wook versus Kang Dae-sang. Jinwoo versus Seja Solda. Jade Tiger versus Park Sang-cho. And GSK Gusan-Q taking on Captain Korea. I hope you've enjoyed this week. If you had, please like up the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. And other than that, we will see you all next time.